Good evening, everybody. My name is John. I'm from Class 5th. Today, my topic is again the universe. I started telling this again, so let's start.
Stars, you can say, they live for more like 15 million years. The black hole
they could have existed, but we don't know. Maybe they still exist. We don't know anything about this. The black hole stars. The black hole is having just push over them, which make them so giant that you can't even imagine. Like I said, like 5 times already. The many stars, like seeing 218, be my king is majority, you my sun time, a very strange dream, might be black hole stars. Because how do they become this big? How? How do you think the Stephen 218 is like 2,000 times the radius of our star? That's like more than 60 million times New York's radius. That's a lot. A lot, a lot. And how can they make it? Maybe they're black hole stars. Baby black hole stars that are maybe about to die in a few million years in a hypernova. Black hole stars are so big also for one more reason. Giant hydrogen clouds are literally a million light years wide. That's what black hole stars actually are, why they're so big. Another type of brown dwarfs, they're literally dead stars. They do nuclear fusion once every unimaginable years. And yes, suddenly they do collapse and do go in a supernova. But we don't want to talk about failed stars. We want to start by the first real star. I was talking about black hole stars, they're giant. Now we're going to the extremely small, which are the size of our Earth, but have the mass of 1.2 times our sun. Red dwarf stars. They have just this much, a tiny bit amount to even nuclear fuse. They can't fuse because they do fuse, but so slow that they can live for literally 10 trillion years. That's like one with 12 zeros. Years. You might be asking, how? Well, because of their nuclear fusion, it's so slow that they can not even fuse fast enough to die. They live for a long time. Next is white dwarf stars. They are basically living less time, but still live for long. Like nearly one trillion years. Let me write that down in words. This is the lifespan for a red dwarf. Let me just write red. This is for a white dwarf. That's the maximum a white dwarf can have, and that's the maximum for a red dwarf. Next, yellow dwarf stars, which we are very common with our own sun. They live for a pretty short time, just like 10 million years. That's 10 times smaller than a normal white star. And yes, in a few million years, our sun will become more bigger than Betelgeuse and R13681, the most massive star in our galaxy. Well, this was a yellow dwarf, then there are many other big stars, like a blue dwarf, then a blue giant, a yellow giant, a red giant, which is actually not that big. Then there's a blue supergiant, a yellow supergiant, a red supergiant. There are many bigger than that, blue hypergiants, red hypergiants, yellow hypergiants, keep on going. And the last is black hole stars. They are the largest thing in the universe. Well, my time's running out, so today we learned